Have you ever wondered why so many mirrors in games are cracked, foggy, or just missing entirely?
Nope.
It's not just a design choice. Mirrors are actually one of the hardest things to get right in game development. But don't worry, you don't need to be a pro to understand how they work. From simple tricks like duplicating the environment to cutting-edge ray tracing, let's explore how reflections have evolved in games, how different techniques work, and when to use what. The oldest trick in the book is literally just copying and flipping the room behind a mirror. This method has been around since the early days of gaming. Games like Duke Nukem 3D and early first-person shooters often use this method. By creating an identical room behind an invisible wall and placing a duplicate of the player character inside, developers can simulate a mirror without any special rendering techniques. Some devs also use these duplicated rooms very creatively, especially in horror games. However, this method comes with significant drawbacks. Since the game is essentially rendering two environments instead of one, memory usage increases. In a complex scene with multiple objects, lights, and interactive elements, this duplication can become a burden on performance. Planar reflections take a more sophisticated approach. Instead of duplicating the environment, the game renders the scene a second time from the mirror's perspective and projects it onto the mirror's surface. This creates an accurate reflection that properly accounts for changes in the environment, including moving objects and dynamic lighting. This technique is effective for mirrors, water, and other flat reflective surfaces. However, the downside is again the performance cost. Rendering the entire scene twice is extremely expensive, especially in graphically intensive games. That's why devs need to be selective when using planar reflections, often limiting them to some locations. Cube maps provide a different kind of reflection, one that's less precise but much cheaper to render. Instead of calculating real-time reflections, cube map takes 6 images from a central point and stitch them together into a cube-shaped texture. This texture is then used to create illusions of reflections on surfaces like windows, metallic objects, or water, and even interiors of buildings. The advantage of cube maps is that they are fast and don't require constant re-rendering. However, they are not truly real-time. If an object moves inside a reflective environment, the reflection won't update accordingly unless the cube map is refreshed. This makes them unsuitable for mirrors but excellent for adding general reflections to a scene. Screen space reflections, or SSR, are a modern solution that offers real-time reflections without the heavy cost of rendering the scene twice. SSR works by tracing the pixels already visible on the screen and calculating reflections based on them. This makes it great for simulating reflections in puddles, wet roads, and glass surfaces. However, SSR has fundamental limitation. It can only reflect what's already visible on the screen. If an object is off-screen, it won't appear in the reflection. Now, the technique that closely resembles the natural properties of light and reflections, ray tracing. It is the best technology for making realistic reflections. Instead of relying on approximations, ray tracing simulates the way light actually bounces in the real world. This means reflections are physically accurate, regardless of surface shape, camera angle, or object movement. Ray traced reflections capture every detail, from the tiniest ripples in water to the glow of neon signs bouncing off glass buildings. However, this comes at a massive computational cost. Games like Cyberpunk 2077 shows the true power of ray traced reflections, making their worlds feel more lifelike than ever before. So, which reflection technique is the best? Well, it depends. If you just need a simple trick, duplicating the environment might do the job. For accurate flat mirrors, planar reflections are great. For general reflections, cube maps work well. If you want real-time reflections without too much cost, SSR is your friend. And if you want the best possible reflections, ray tracing is the way to go, if your hardware can handle it. If you ever get confused, just have a quick glance at this picture to figure out what to use and how they work. Now that you know the tricks behind them, you will never look at game mirrors the same way again.